Good evening, everybody. Welcome to She Said, She Said. Thank you for joining us. It's another Saturday night. Make sure you join us every Saturday night for just an hour. Now, tonight on the show, you're going to be glad you're watching because we have a set of brothers who are really quite intriguing. Now, she says she still can't believe they're brothers, and if she were to go out with one, she's not going to tell you who, so that's just for me to know. Don't giggle!
Hey. And she said that they are the most good-looking brothers in Congress.
Yes, in the lower house.
In the lower house.
We'll meet them in just a few, so don't you go away. She said, she said, you're watching Jackie and I, and with us are the brothers that we've been talking about. We're talking about Bullet Jalosjos and John Jalosjos. Bullet, you represent the?
I represent the 1st District of Zamboanga del Norte.
Zamboanga del Norte, and John?
2nd District of Zamboanga, Sibugay.
Okay, how many districts are there in Zamboanga?
There's Zamboanga City, there's Zamboanga Sibugay, and there's Zamboanga del Norte. In my province, Zamboanga del Norte, we have 3 districts.
Oh. So how many congressmen all in all? Like,
3.
Again. Wait. Okay, Zamboanga, Sibugay.
No, this is Zamboanga Peninsula. Zamboanga Peninsula consists of Zamboanga City, Zamboanga Sibugay, Zamboanga del Norte, and Zamboanga del Sur.
That's right.
Okay.
That was four.
Four provinces. 3 provinces and 1 city.
Okay, 3 provinces and 1 city. And you are the congressman in the 1st district
of Zamboanga del Norte.
Del Norte. And you are 2nd district of
Zamboanga Sibugay. Another province.
You know, you'll just have to take me there.
Yeah. One of these days.
Okay, where is Dakak?
Dakak is
who are you asking to take you there? Which one?
Both.
Where is Dakak? Who's
my district.
Your district.
That's in Dapitan City. Okay, that's where Rizal was exiled.
Dapitan.
Yes.
Right.
So Dapitan is in Zamboanga. I never knew that.
It is.
Yeah.
I thought Dapitan was in
Rizal, yeah?
Yes.
Yeah, I know. Where were we during history class? We weren't even classmates.
I went to the bathroom.
I was having
a snack. Wait, so both your father was a
congressman.
Congressman.
Well,
he was first an assemblyman, and then he ran for Senate, and then he ran for governor, and then he ran for Congress.
Yes. But I remember the governor.
Yeah, he's known for Congress.
In his district.
In my district.
So you're taking your dad's place.
Before. But it was
your dad is on the 3rd term.
No. My dad was he couldn't run, so my tita was the one who was congresswoman.
Your tita.
Yeah, she finished her term. 3 terms and then I ran out.
Your mother is not in I keep thinking show business. Your mother is not in politics.
No, my mom is a singer. She's in show business also.
Oh, she is.
See, show business. I was right.
Lorna Pal.
Oh, so can you sing?
Is she
your
mom?
No, wait. So,
we got
this wrong, right? He's singing and you're dancing.
No.
No, that's what you said.
How can she be your mom? It's like she's so young.
Yeah, she looks young, but...
So, okay, can you, like, sing for us a little?
No, I can't.
Come on, what did you do for the campaign?
I didn't sing.
What did he sing?
I actually...
A lot.
No. Like what?
Imagine,
John Lennon?
Wait, he wasn't there, so you wouldn't know.
Did you sing?
Did you dance?
No.
Or you just smiled?
Just smiled,
that's it.
Really?
Smile, talk, rode my bike.
Hey, do you have sisters?
Yes.
Yeah, I do.
And actually, are they singers or are they politicians?
There's singers and politicians.
Singer and politicians.
Wait, Lana. She's in repertory as well.
She's now the mayor of...
Oh, really?
Yeah, of Miss Occidental, Balyangao.
Another province.
Right.
Miss Occidental.
Yeah.
Did you watch Dreamgirls?
Misamis.
She's got a fantastic voice. Is she your blood sister? Full sister.
Yeah. She's my full sister.
Hence the voice.
Yeah.
Right.
So, Miss Occidental is Misamis Occidental. I thought it was like Miss Philippines.
I know.
Yeah.
Right?
No, shortcut.
Shortcut.
Okay, I have to learn all these shortcuts.
Yeah, I know.
And your other sister is?
How many sisters do you have?
Two,
full,
right?
Full sisters.
Full?
Yeah.
Me?
Yeah.
I'm alone.
Oh, just you. And you have one full sister?
One full sister.
Okay. And you have one more brother, I hear, who's also in politics.
Yeah, he's actually the governor of Zamboanga Sibugay, their province.
Oh, okay. Ah. Do you vote for the governor?
No, that's a totally different province. So we have our own governor, He has his own governor, which is apparently our brother, so which is right. a lot easier in his part.
That's so strange.
So is this your first, second, third term?
They're both first-termers.
Yeah. Oh, you're both first-termers.
First term, but I was a board member before I ran for Congress.
How many terms?
Which is one term, just 3 years. Term, yeah. And he was a mayor.
Oh,
you're a mayor.
Oh, okay, you're one of the 23 mayors that yes. are in... There are 23 mayors who are in,
now
Congress,
in Congress
right now. Yeah.
Okay, you had been mayor for how many terms?
One term.
Oh, I see.
So what did you do? I'm sure you danced and sang.
No. He danced and sang.
What did he?
Actually,
okay.
He doesn't sing.
Okay, why don't we tell each other the most embarrassing moments about your brother?
What about starting off this way? Okay, John, tell us things that people don't know about Bullet.
About Bullet and Bullet. After, no, you start with one, and then you can tell
yeah,
us
okay.
something people don't know about John.
Okay.
So you have to be nice because he's going to be next.
Yeah. Don't tell him to be nice. Let him be naughty.
Condo, so.
No, actually,
it's okay,
house.
It's okay.
Okay, go, John.
You can lock something, the door if he says something
Something
bad.
We don't know.
Something you don't know.
Yeah.
Something embarrassing.
Okay. No, it doesn't have to
embarrassing.
Be anything.
Embarrassing, all right?
Embarrassing.
Okay. This guy is so afraid of cockroaches.
Oh my God, yeah. I can just like
he could
kill them.
It before in the province.
Okay, I don't know if I want to go out with them. I mean, if there's a cockroach coming
yeah.
at me.
I kill the cockroaches.
No.
Okay, I just get it and kill it, whatever. Unless they start flying.
Yeah, I don't like flying. Okay.
And other insects.
And other insects.
Yeah, no
okay.
Insects.
Okay.
What about girls who look like insects?
Especially those.
Especially yeah, those.
Especially those.
Okay, and you, tell us something about John.
He's actually, well, he was really shy before, so he sang, because I can't forget, he sang in his school once, and he fainted. Because some girls passed by, and he was so embarrassed, so he actually fainted on the floor.
Lady, what did you sing?
I forgot.
At least you were the one who fainted. Can you imagine if they heard you sing and they fainted?
Yeah, I know.
That's funny. I mean, did you faint through mid-song or
mid-song.
When the girls
okay.
started coming
it was,
out.
It was because you couldn't breathe because you
or
were
did
embarrassed
you like a girl?
Or
no, I didn't.
You got dizzy or what?
I got dizzy. I don't know.
Well, what are your memories of that? You just
he's laughing at you.
I know.
No, because he's the naughty one.
No. Yeah. Wait, did you have an earring?
Yeah.
Do you have an earring?
No, I don't.
You can't afford.
No. Actually, I did. I just took them off.
Who had the earring first?
I did.
What's your age difference?
I'm 30, turning 31. September.
I think it's 8 years.
Eight mm-hmm. years.
Yeah. So you're 22.
38. Now I'm younger.
Oh,
but you guys like really grew up together.
Yeah,
so that's why you're
we're really, really
good
close.
Friends. And
we're really, really close.
Really close?
Yeah.
Would you say like you're each other's best friends?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
You said yes, but he didn't answer.
Yeah.
I'm locking the door to our condo.
Yeah,
but how could you be shy if you were a mayor? That's the job that just deals with everyone.
I think it's nice to have a shy mayor.
Yeah, it is. I can. Yeah, I'm really a bit shy.
Well, he was shy, and then when he entered politics, everything changed.
Okay, and so you had how many terms as mayor?
One term only.
One term mayor and then
Congress.
And then you one term board member and then Congress.
That's right.
So do you think you're going to run for the same office or another office in the next year?
Probably the same.
And
you know,
John?
Hopefully the same.
So why are you liking Congress more than being a mayor? That's
oh yeah, why did
most
you decide?
People decide.
Yeah, why did you
yeah,
decide
if it was
to
only
run?
Only your first term, then you could have had
two more terms.
I know. Necessity in our political party, one.
Which is what party?
A local party. Mm-hmm. It's a local party. We call it APP.
You're affiliated with
APP.
Yes.
What's it stand for?
Alliance
for Peace and
Peace
Progress.
Peace and Progress.
Progress.
Okay.
It's in Mindanao. And two is, I couldn't do anything if you're a mayor because you're just being boxed in by all of these laws. So
couldn't do anything meaning...
I cannot do anything. You know.
Because?
Because era-based, uh-huh. financially, you can't do anything. Lost.
But I thought if you're a mayor, if you have a project, then you can implement it, not like in Congress. It takes
yeah, but
a long time.
You're being barred by some laws that you cannot do. So you have to tell your
boss.
Congressman to
be the one to implement.
To be the one to, make or propose or change those laws, like
right.
distribution of lands, because production of good citizen needs one is labor.
Oh.
They need jobs.
Mm-hmm.
So if you don't have any factories in your towns or municipalities. You have to create land opportunities, which is farming. So there's a big land, there, government land, that I have to distribute, but I cannot because of this law. So I was
fed
up.
Because of the laws. But if you don't think about the laws and you're going to implement something else, then you can just do it right away. I mean, you don't have to pass anything.
What was your population?
It's about 40,000.
40,000? That's your voting population?
Yeah.
What about yours?
In my district?
Yeah.
District? Or,
yeah, district.
Or my municipality?
District.
A district is about 200.
200,000. And in yours?
Mine is around almost 300. 290.
So did you go house to house?
I did.
Did?
Yeah.
Did you have to? No need, because you're a mayor.
No need, but you have to. I did it anyway.
It's
so.
just more fulfilling.
But you guys had did anybody even dare to go up against you guys?
Yeah, actually, we all had opponents. My opponent was actually the son of my dad's opponent during his time. So it was a big rival.
How far was
son to son?
Son to son.
Son to son.
I mean, yeah, okay.
Yeah. How far was the the win?
Well,
how many votes did you get?
74,000.
And he got?
14,000.
Oh,
14
only,
yeah.
Or
14,000? John, 11. Okay, we were not in convent in that province anyway. We have the stronghold in Zamboanga del Norte,
right?
Which he is, and my uncle, one of our uncle is the congressman also and the governor. We just went there and ran there, so we were not in convent.
So you just took a chance there.
We took a chance there.
And so how many votes did you get?
I got 84.
And the next in line?
70 plus.
Oh,
so
wow.
Very close.
Do you agree a lot when it comes to like political issues?
Political issues?
Or you disagree
more?
No. What do you disagree
with? A lot.
For example?
We can't talk to
these. A lot of
you can't talk about it on television.
Okay, so they can tell us during the break.
We can talk about it during the gap, and then we'll be the ones
to
tell
you.
Yeah,
we'll tell you.
Because we're allowed to talk about it, and you're not, right?
Yes.
Now I want to ask Bullet, why do you enjoy the national position, Congress, more than being a board member?
Well, actually, I don't really, in comparison to a board member, it was an easier transition in my part because it was still the legislative branch of government being a board member. So what happened was, I think it just upgraded, or I just got promoted to a national position. So it was a lot easier for me. Right now, I'm enjoying it, maybe because we haven't been working, not yet, because we don't have our committees yet. We're still in the verge of organizing, and now it's getting busy, though. I just missed my first committee hearing
this afternoon?
Yeah, appropriations.
Oh, okay.
How many committees are you
I know why, because I saw you out last night. You went home earlier, yet you were the one who didn't make it to the meeting.
No, actually, I just went home to change. And
I see. You know what? We are going to have to go on a break, but we'll talk to them more when we get back, so don't you go away.
Nagbabalik po ang She Said, She Said at kasama pa rin po natin ang magkapatid na Jalosjos from the lower house.
Look, oh, black, white.
I know.
Sinadya ba yan?
Actually, no, but we actually have different personalities. So.
Really? Okay, how different are you guys?
I'm more the outgoing. He's more the
shy
reserved.
Type.
Not really shy, but reserved.
Yaki hardly makes hirit, but when he makes hirit,
impake, no?
Yeah. It's one thing that you'll remember forever.
You can be brothers the way we can be sisters. Right?
Yeah, exactly.
But they're real brothers. So do you think your dad's being in politics had influence on you guys since you were kids? Did you always know you were going to be in politics?
Yeah, okay. How old did you...
That's the difference that we had. Like, me, ever since I was... I think I had that inclination that I wanted to...
Like, how old were you?
When was that? I think we were 15.
And so what did you want to be when you were 15?
I was just curious.
Singer!
Do you want to ask me? Do you want me to answer that?
Yes. Can you please answer?
But not 15.
No, okay, not 15.
Skateboardist.
Oh yeah, I wanted to be a skater.
What? A skateboardist?
I was
skater
also,
boy.
Skater boy.
And how old were you then?
About 11.
29.
Around 17. No.
11.
Yeah. 11. And then when did you want to enter show business? Politics.
When we started going out campaigning for my dad, actually.
Oh. And then I started getting. You were 17.
No, I was around 13.
13,
14, 15.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And you liked it.
Yeah, we were exposed at a very, very young age.
What exactly did you
like
about
it? Okay,
how
did you campaign for your dad? You have to sing and dance, of course.
No, just the fact that we were there and we were the kids and we were saying, you know how, if you're young and you know, it's cute.
So you spoke.
What
did you say? Do you remember what you were saying then?
Well, we introduced ourselves as our
like,
son.
Okay, let's pretend.
Okay, go.
Let's
take you back. Let's take you back 5 years ago.
No, there you go.
What language is it there?
Bisaya.
So, okay.
So, can you say it in Bisaya?
Go. Come on.
That's okay. Next time when we're
no.
He's so shy. Oh, John, you tell us.
No, actually, I'm not the speaker because I'm a shy guy. So, I'm the organizer. I used to hold
I organize
the youth in the whole province.
Mm-hmm.
So,
but during the campaign, you have to be up there.
No, I was the worker. I'm a worker, so I'm always at the back.
So you don't believe that you have to have the gift of gab to be a politician?
Excuse me?
You don't believe that one has to be like outgoing and talkative and
I also believe that, but my asset lies on organizing.
But what about like public speaking? You're okay with that? Because, you know, as mayor, I'm sure you had to give like 10 speeches a day.
Okay, there's a joke from my counselors and my vice mayor.
Which is?
Every time I had a speech or make a speech, they always look at their watch.
Why? Because they knew it would be really short.
Yeah, 2 minutes.
2 minutes.
1 minute.
1 minute.
30 seconds. They bet on it.
But you know what? There's nothing wrong with that. I think it's better to say something short so people are listening,
that's right.
Opposed to talking for 10 minutes where no one even gets anything anymore because they get ADHD.
Or say something and promise, and then not do anything about it.
Right. Or talk for 10 minutes about like senseless
stuff.
Yeah, I
mean, what do you think about people who just speak well, but then they don't do anything? I mean, they just talk and talk and talk, and it's all talk. All their promises are empty.
That's their assets then.
Well, that's true.
But then they get away with it.
So you're like known as the suave one, and you're...
Suave? The kalat one?
The kalat one.
No, I'm just more outgoing.
Okay, what about girls? Did you ever like the same girl?
I don't like girls. No, I'm just kidding. No.
That was my next question. Or boys. But okay, since you answered
it. No.
Quote and go.
Yeah, no. If we like the same girls.
The same girls.
Has it ever happened?
I think we have a totally different.
Okay, let's make your brother tell us what kind of girls you go for.
Yes.
Tall.
What is his type? You will go for tall girls.
He goes for tall girls.
So if you have children, they will be.
That's not hard. Everyone's taller than me.
I know.
Okay, go. Tall.
Tall. Pageant tall.
Pageant tall. Majorly tall.
Major.
What about skin?
Before he likes morena, but now he really likes white.
White.
Why the change
tall
in color?
And then white.
I don't know. Maybe it's just a mix. I like mixing.
If you
had a girlfriend that's morena, and then after that you'd want to.
Personality wise, what were they like?
How come it's just me?
No, you get to answer later.
Personality-wise.
Did you like his girlfriends?
Some of them, yeah.
Not romantically,
what about the others that you didn't like? Why didn't you like them?
Excuse me?
The ones that you didn't like, what was it about them that you didn't like? And did you tell him?
Of course, he knows someone.
He knows? How did you say?
I just say.
Ayoko siya?
No, bro. Like, bro, medyo ganito siya.
Medyo ano? What's ganito?
Yeah, for example, without naming names.
Medyo kalat.
Kalat. What does kalat mean? Like for
scattered.
A girl? What is,
yeah, what's scattered?
Kalat.
Like,
what?
All over the place. Like
all over the place.
Meaning messy as a person?
Not just messy, like when you talk to someone, when you introduce her, and she's
kalat yung
all over. Yeah.
Oh,
baka bobo.
Okay.
I mean,
kalat lang. Not,
just
not,
scattered.
Yeah.
Or childish.
So did you agree?
Immature.
Or how did you feel when your brother told you those things? Did you actually take it into consideration?
No, actually,
or you're like,
I still like her, I don't care.
Agree.
Okay, you agreed?
Yeah, I think, okay.
Or maybe you didn't see it
or
first,
you didn't realize it until he pointed it out.
Yeah, I did, but I was just, maybe I was waiting for someone else to
tell you.
Yeah.
Do you wait for him to tell you, or you know anyway he's going to do it?
Well, I would know.
Do you ask him for advice when it comes to love?
Guys don't do that.
What?
No, they don't. Guys don't do that, right? No, they never do. They just talk about things, but they never ask, what do you think?
Really?
No.
About love?
Yeah. See, that's not a guy thing. I've never known any guy to do that.
Look at his face. About love?
What's that?
Okay, now let's talk about him. What kinds of girlfriends did he have? Yeah. No. About him.
He's actually one, he's only had two girlfriends.
What? Okay.
And two wives. So, there you go.
The two girlfriends, but at the same time.
That's a joke.
But at the same time.
No, not at the same time. He's been married twice and he's had two girlfriends.
Really?
That's a joke.
Okay, wait.
You've been married twice and you've had two girlfriends. Were any of the girls the same or you've had four all in all?
What do you mean?
Were the girls like the one that you married?
No, it's a joke. That's a joke.
But he's so serious, and we believe him.
It's a joke.
Over me?
Your friends from your Balikbayan friends are laughing.
Yeah, so, your friends who don't even know their names, and you call
what
them.
What about?
Friends.
Yeah, really. So he's had.
He's had two girlfriends.
And what were they like?
What's his type?
Well, they're totally different personalities, also.
Who did you like more? The
current one now. Yeah. I haven't met the first one. I heard about her.
And what did you hear? Good or bad things?
A lot of bad things. I was like, man, leave her.
So, you would really tell him?
Yeah. I would.
Same thing. Without him asking, you would tell him?
Yeah.
Was there ever a time that any of you fell in love and the other one didn't like the person for you and then you didn't talk for a while because...
No.
Nothing like that?
No, not really.
Oh. But would it matter? Like, what if he told you, I don't like this, this girl's kind of kalat? Would it matter that he kind of said that so you kind of feel awkward about bringing them together? Like,
I wouldn't care. At least I got his side, I tried to collect a lot of information.
So do you talk about your parents, about your relationships?
Excuse me?
Do you ask for advice?
From our parents?
Yeah.
You do? Yeah. Your mom. Do you guys talk to your mom?
Yeah. I'm very close with my mom also.
Really? So are you the youngest?
Yeah, I'm the youngest.
I can't believe she has two grown-up boys. I mean, she used to guest in my noontime show. See, and that was way before, and I can't believe that you came out of her.
I want to ask you where you got your name. How did your mom come up with Bullet?
No, actually, my dad was the one who named me Bullet.
Really?
It was because of during that time, 1970s, our dad used to have, he used to produce, or was it?
Yeah, produce.
Produce PBA basketball.
Okay. And
then, it was vintage.
Yeah.
Before vintage, it was that. I think it was called...
Also tape. Eh?
No. Tape was the second.
And then he was the one that brought Washington Bullets at that time to the Philippines to have a friendly game or a tournament with the Philippine team. And during that time, during the championships, when they ended up winning, that was when I was born.
So you became Bullet.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Actually, it was just me and my mom and then they were all watching the game.
Really? Yeah. So did you have a hard time, like, your name is like Bullet? That's your real name?
No, that's my nickname. Everyone calls
me
Bullet.
Okay, what is your real name?
My real name is Seth Frederick.
Why are you laughing? What is it again? Seth Frederick?
Seth Frederick.
Seth. Nice.
Well, what is your real name?
Now you can laugh.
Romeo. Yeah.
See?
Yeah,
that's what is he's laughing about his name too.
Oh, okay.
So do people all say, where's Juliet?
Yeah.
What do you answer?
I use it for my campaign.
I must look for my Juliet.
Yeah.
There you go.
I see. And that's ako pa si Juliet, ako pa. Like that?
So there are all these girls named Juliet, right?
Yeah, they're always.
Suddenly,
and are they always good looking?
Not all. Yeah,
okay. And on that note, we're going to pause for a little break and talk more to the boys when we come back. Nagbabalik po ang She Said. If you're just joining us, make sure you log on to Facebook, add us on your fan page, She Said. With us are the brothers, Bullet, otherwise known as Seth, Jalosjos, and Romeo.
Romeo.
John. Well, how'd you get your name? That's not even close. John and Romeo.
My father's name is Romeo, so Junior is John John. Oh.
Junior, John John. Junior?
Yeah, Junior.
So Romeo, Romeo Junior.
So you're Junior.
Yeah. What is your John name?
John John.
Oh, John John. Okay, I didn't know Junes are Johns. I thought Johns are just a whole separate name.
Why? Is Huh?
Yeah, he's a Junior. That's why he's John.
Why?
Exactly.
Junior?
Okay, sa Bisaya.
When I was young, they called me Junjun.
And then Jan Jan.
And then I went to the States, they called me
Jan Jan.
Having a hard time calling Jun.
Oh, people in the States, so they can't say Jun.
Janyar. Yun na nga.
Janyar.
I see. Okay, okay, how's your mom?
She's good. She's at home.
At home here in the Philippines.
Yeah. Are your mom's friends?
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Okay.
Cool.
And your mom, I haven't seen her in the longest time. Does she still sing?
She still sings. She sings in, well, sometimes in Australia, she still sings. Ah. She still has that voice.
So you took after her?
No, I just got the height, that's it.
So your mom, I can't imagine your mom having grown-up children.
She's talking about Lorna Powell, if you just joined us.
Because she, I mean, what I remember of her is like she's so young.
Yeah, she still looks young.
And you probably look older than she does because she really looks young. And she plays tennis, you said?
She plays tennis a lot.
Mm-hmm. And you were talking about playing tennis with her for how long?
No, she plays.
Well, how did that happen, John? Well, how did she end up playing from 6
p.m. to 6 a.m.?
6 a.m.
They visited us in the compound of the Jalosjos compound.
And there's a tennis court?
There's a tennis court, and then...
Yeah, this friendly game that ended.
That doesn't sound so friendly.
I know,
6 a.m.
That's why. That's
like, who against who?
I love my wife.
Yeah.
Your wife against his mom.
Mom and another girls.
And some friends.
Two more girls.
Tita. So just the four of them played till 6 a.m.
Yeah, we played a little bit. We played.
Oh, so you both play tennis.
What else do you play?
I know they both play. They both play basketball.
Every Monday.
Okay, why are you laughing?
He's laughing because. See, Seth here, when he plays from basketball, he changes to his badminton outfit. So we just like cross the hall in Congress because the basketball's here. They play with Manny Pacquiao and a lot of the other second-termer and first-termers. Mm-hmm. And so to go to the other side, he changes shoes, which is supposed to be right because it's got to be different shoes.
Uh-huh.
But it doesn't end there. Tell us what.
What?
It's a complete outfit. Test to match the racket.
Aww, what color is your racket?
Black and white.
Black and white.
So hanggang sa shoes, black and white, black and white, black and white. That's why he's laughing. Because he pointed it out to me. I'm like, oh my God, you're right.
That's true. And what did you wear for basketball?
I saw something. Yeah. There's a tattoo. What does it say?
Well, it's...
In your leg?
No,
yeah, I just saw it.
It's a birthmark.
It's not a birthmark. It's a...
No, it's a small.
Are you Indian?
A girl?
No. Back in
what's
the...
it? Okay, what does his tattoo say?
Wala.
Come on, John.
Just a mark.
It's a girl's name. Because
no,
if it was just a design, you'd
girl's
show
name.
It.
I wouldn't put a girl's name.
Yes, you would. Name, your mom.
Oh, see? So
no.
Your girlfriend's name was also Lorna.
No, it's not a name.
Okay,
so...
What is it? Show us.
Yeah, later.
Okay, so you were wearing your basketball outfit. And are you also particular with that?
In badminton,
Really?
Yeah. Security has seen my
So
my
badminton
his
well?
Expert moves. Expert he said he was pro, so I was like really scared. So we did girls against boys. Susan and I against.
And
played
won.
With you.
Mark
at that point.
Like, do you serve here?
Oh, that kind of pro.
No. You know what kind of player Mark is? The other guy, Mark Villar, mm-hmm. Congressman Mark Villar. He arrives and he tells me, I'm going to go next week and I'm going to bring rackets. I go, bring shuttlecocks, okay? He's like, yeah, the one that comes with a racket. I thought he was kidding. He gets there with this plastic container of the badminton rackets that are 2-in-1 with the shuttlecocks that are rubber. He wasn't kidding.
The toy ones?
Yes, the toy ones. The the garden badminton rackets.
My God.
And
the one you buy in the grocery?
And he uses that to play. Yeah, the ones that you can find in the grocery store.
Why don't you lend him a racket?
No, I want him to play lousy so we can beat him. So they played against us.
And you won.
So, they displayed we
your
play.
Clothes.
Display, yes. You can't
if you
play,
can't play, display.
Display,
so you're only starting to learn badminton now.
No, they used to play.
Yeah, I used to play, but really, you know, rusty.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh, okay. So basketball and badminton, and you sing and you dance, and what else?
Do you guys go diving? Golf?
Yeah, we're divers. Yes.
You're both divers.
We're licensed divers.
Paddy Nawi.
Paddy.
Okay, and then how often do you dive?
As often as we could.
Yeah, if we have time.
Mm-hmm. But you can't really go out of town all the time now.
No, now we're actually schedule's been really busy.
So you fly every week?
Every week. Every Thursdays we go home to the province.
And then
Mondays
you come back?
Every Mondays.
Monday morning?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So Thursday you get there at night?
Afternoon.
And then Friday, you only have. So you really only have like one whole weekday.
One whole week, yeah.
Do you guys go home every weekend?
Yeah.
Do you travel together?
Sometimes. Yeah, sometimes.
Yeah, they did travel together last week.
Yeah.
That's.